Hello everyone, and welcome to another edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials. My name is Richard Evans, and today's subject is going over the new way to record within the new TriCaster 7.1 software, which you can download right now at newtek.com/downloads. Now, you can record how you normally would with your different four mix outputs, but now there's another way to record ISO record individual inputs. So let's dive in and show you how that's done. All right, so here we are in the TriCaster TC1 interface, and the first thing that I want to show you is where you would go to configure the recordings that you want to capture on the TriCaster. So we'll go over to this corner of my program window and click on this gear icon, and we'll open up this output configuration window. Now from here, you have the four different mixes that can be either going out via SDI to projector, jumbotron, monitor, whatever, or can just be sent out as an NDI feed, etc., or they'll just basically be your recordings. So right now I have my mix number one as my program, my mix number two is input five, mix number three is input two, mix number four is input four, whatever. Okay, so let's change this around a little bit. I'm just gonna do input number two for my mix number one. We'll just kinda go down the road here and get three and four. So, all right, so we got inputs two, three, and four here. Cool, so now we'll move over to my recording tab on the output configuration, and this is where I would go to configure those mix recordings. So I can do a whole lot here. From here, I can set a checkbox next to making sure that I actually record that mix number one. I can set it up to where I can have an instant replay being broadcast out as well. I can set the recording path to this. I can do either one of my internal drives or to like an external USB 3.0 drive, an eSATA drive, or a network attached storage drive like the new NewTek remote storage, for example. And then I can go ahead and name these files. So this one, I'm just going to name that my program. And then mix number two, let's do the same thing. I want an instant replay, and I'm going to call that my biker. All right, and then we'll go ahead and do the same thing for mix three. I'm just going to leave that titled mix three because I'm lazy, and mix four as well. Okay, so now as soon as I hit record, I am now going to be recording my mix one, two, three, and four all at the same time. And again, those are going to be assigned to the sources that I have determined over here on the output side. Okay, so now I will hit record and we are off and running. I am recording all four of those inputs at the same time. Now, what's cool about this is you still can get some replay action out of this system, and that is just going to be by clicking on the number that you want to bring as a instant replay. But you're going to do this on your keyboard that comes with your system here. So before we do that, let me click on this gear icon here. I'm going to say I want my replay duration to be about 8 seconds. My replay speed, I can select between 100, 200, and let's go down to 50%. And then what I want to do is I want to have those replays show up in my DDR1 bin whenever I take to them, okay? So now, I only have instant replay that I've selected on both my recording mix number one and mix number two. So to access them using the keyboard included with your TriCaster, I can simply click on two to bring that in. So let's watch our biker here, and now hit two. Got about a couple seconds there. Boom. And then it'll automatically play on the output of my system. So you'll see it's already playing out at 50% speed. So this is great for an instant replay to just bring right into your broadcast. Now there's another way of being able to capture different videos as well. Instead of just recording your mix outputs, you can also ISO record individual inputs coming into the system. Because let's say that you have your mix one, two, three, and four all doing separate things, like they're going out to sources, like they're being a confidence monitor. You basically ran out of sources coming out of the system, but you still want to ISO record a specific input. Well, with a new recording feature, you can do exactly that. So let's go over here into input number five. Well, you know, yeah, that's input number five. It's my basketball game. And if I click in here, you'll see that I now have an option for recording and capturing directly from within the input 5 setting. So I can send that again to any file path I want it to be. I can also record from here as well. So without doing any changes to my recordings of my mix 1, 2, 3, and 4 over here, I can be recording. And now you'll see here as well, I have options to bring those in. So right now you'll see that I have a recording button underneath my three and four, just to indicate that that is one of the sources that is being recorded on my mix outputs. But then also input number 5, I have these options of bringing in replays directly into my broadcast. So we're gonna watch this basketball game here, and then what's cool about this is I have two different ways of bringing those on. If I click on the replay option here on my program row, it will just automatically play that out into my program output. But if I click the one below here, that will allow me to create an instant replay that will just send up into my DDR and will sit there until I want to use it again. So, all right, let's go ahead and we'll watch this guy do his free throw because we're going to want an instant replay of that for some reason. I don't know. All right. And he did it. Good. So we'll go ahead and click that button on number 5. And now check it out. In my DDR, I have that basketball clip playing at 50%. I'm ready to go and can roll that out into my broadcast whenever I want. Or I can do it directly onto my program output. So let's say here, oh, looks like there's a foul away from the ball. Let's go ahead and click on this button here. And now it'll bring that replay directly into my program output at 50%. So as you can see, you have more recording capabilities. So you can record just your inputs or just your mixes or a combination of both and have new access to different instant replay methods. Now, if you like this tutorial but want a little bit more, make sure you go to newtek.com/demo to sign up for a free personalized TriCaster demonstration hosted by yours truly. Also, be sure to follow us and tag us in your Instagram posts. Also, for more videos like this, go to our YouTube page, which is youtube.com/newtekinc. And for more information about all of our systems, visit newtek.com or call your local reseller. Until then, thank you for watching, and be sure to tune in next time for another edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials.